Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and I'm here to talk about the Wii U and its future. Really, it's not a topic I'm too knowledgeable about, but it's something that I do think about quite often, simply because Nintendo is always usually in such an interesting position in regards to the other console manufacturers. It always feels like Sony and Microsoft are kind of just like going at it with each other, and Nintendo is like off on its own corner doing their own thing, and that's kind of how it's been for the past two generations or so. So it's always interesting. It's a weird picture now because there's a lot of doomsayers right now about the Wii U. You know, is it gonna bomb as much as GameCube or go worse? Some people are starting to rage up the notion that Nintendo should get out of the hardware business altogether and just start developing games like what happened with Sega. I almost said Sega, sorry. Like what happened with Sega. You know, Sega used to develop consoles and hardware, but now they're just a publisher company that just makes games and puts them on all platforms, regardless of what console it is. Is it time for Nintendo to start going that route? The fact that we're actually even considering that question just is a good indicator of how Wii U is not doing so well. You know, it's not doing so well right now. But there's a lot of people in the industry, of course, that always stick with this philosophy: you don't underestimate Nintendo. They will pull through even with whatever things they have. Like with the 3DS, you know, it started out super slow, just like how Wii U is right now. 3DS at one point was at that stage like the Wii U, and now there's no doubt nobody's talking about 3DS like it's a failure or that it has a bleak future. You know, 3DS is doing really well. It's coming out with it has come out with good software. There's a lot to be excited and anticipating for the 3DS. And the Wii U is kind of in a situation where the 3DS was, and kind of where GameCube was, and kind of how Wii U was at the end of its life cycle. Not the Wii U, but the original Wii was at the end of its life cycle. People are kind of downplaying it. The biggest problem with Nintendo consoles has usually always been with third-party support and how weak that is. And it's especially true with the Wii U, and that hurts it so much to the fact that we really don't know how well the Wii U is going to do once PS4 and Xbox One are released. It can really go either way, because no matter what happens with Wii U, Nintendo can I feel like Nintendo is strong enough to not have to. It's gonna take much more than like a total failure of the Wii U for Nintendo to be forced out of the console race altogether. It's gonna take much more than Wii U, and I don't think Wii U is gonna be a failure like that, because even if Nintendo has absolutely no third-party support at all with the Wii U, fact of the matter is, people love the games Nintendo makes. People will buy Wii U simply just solely for Nintendo games, for the first-party games. And so Wii U probably will not do as well as the Wii did. I don't think it will sell over 100 million units as the Wii did. I don't think it needs to in order for Nintendo to still make a good amount of profit, to still be considered a big player in the console and in the gaming industry, because Nintendo first party games have sold really well. The hardcore stuff has not sold well with the Wii, which is interesting, because when you think about new Nintendo IPs, people are just always clamoring right now for, like, Nintendo needs to make new IPs. You know, we're sick of the Marios, we're sick of the Zeldas, you know, all this old stuff that's been so long, like 20-year franchises, they need to make new stuff. But actually, if you look back, Nintendo has come up with new IPs with the Wii and the DS. just it's just not something that, you know, gamers think mostly about. You know, Wii Fit, Wii Sports, that's a new IP. It's actually become a franchise now. I'm thinking of something else. Like, I know Wii Music was kind of a new IP that was a failure. I am thinking of something like that's been really big. But yeah, Wii Sports was one thing. Wii Fit was a huge deal. So, like, every Nintendo IP, new IP that was made, you know, that a lot of hardcore gamers don't think about, was a huge success. People will buy Nintendo consoles just for Nintendo games. So there's no doubt in my mind that Wii U will do at least do okay and do good enough. But it does make me wonder about third-party support with the release of Xbox One and PS4. One question is it already too late for Wii U now to get any kind of third-party support? Because obviously it can't catch up technologically. The technical specs of a Wii U is so much behind the specs of Xbox One and PS4. And so a lot of developers who developed games for those two higher tier systems, it's less likely that they will make a port for the Wii U, in which case Wii U is going to be left out of the picture. So it's going to be like these games are exclusively for PC, PS4, and Xbox One, but Wii U you won't be able to play on it. That might be happening, you know? So in that case, the future of the Wii U does not look good at all. That really does mean that people who buy a Wii U and stick to Wii U are only doing so for the first-party Nintendo games. But I think it could also go the other way. Because the development cost of making a game in this generation has already been super high with this level of graphical fidelity. But developing a game for Xbox One and PlayStation 4 and the PC with a much higher, you know, the specs are higher, the expectations are higher. We now expect so much out of the graphics, so much out of technology and graphics. We look at a couple of studios that are now actually, Metal Gear Solid 5 is a good example. David Hayter is no longer a voice actor, but I think that's part of the reason is because they didn't want just a voice actor, but also an actor that can actually demonstrate facial expressions so that can be used. So gaming industry is growing, becoming like Hollywood in a sense with humongous budgets and having to do mocap, acting. L.A. Noire did kind of this where they hired actual actors who acted out the lines and was actually, the computer graphics was, there was a camera system, the camera technology that captured their acting. So the cost is going up. The ridiculous cost of making games is going up. But in that sense, it's cheaper. If you have a system like the Wii U, which does well, which sells enough units, but making games for it is not as expensive as making a game for a PS4 or Xbox One, what could be happening is Wii U could end up getting a great significant amount of third-party exclusive games. In which case, I think that would be really something that really boosts Wii U up. So that on that count, like I don't know where the future of the Wii U, what the future of the Wii U might look like. If the Wii U stays at this stagnant level of sales, I do feel like Wii U is kind of done, and I feel like Nintendo should focus on the next console to release, or actually just have Wii U as its, you know, just focus on their first party games and just kind of rely on that. But if it's to the point where there's a bunch of developers who don't have enough money as humongous big publishers and developers like EA and Activision and whatever, and they want to make, you know, a game that sells well on a console that has a good amount of audience for it, developing exclusively for Wii U might not be such a bad idea. Or make games on the Wii U first and then kind of port that over to the, you know, PS4 and Xbox One as like a downloadable title. I wonder like what the route would be for that. And also, there is this whole debacle of how digital distribution is being handled, is going to be handled by Microsoft and Sony. We now know like the official policy of official statement for Microsoft about what they're going to do with how they're going to deal with used games and digital distribution and such. On the Wii U, it's been released. There is no problem how it functions. It's a traditional method, still exists. You can buy a disc, you put the disc in, you play it, you put the disc back, and you can do whatever you want with it. There is no confusion about what you can do with your games with the Wii U. So that might be a really big plus, because that kind of clarity doesn't exist with Xbox One and PS4 right now. And going further down the road, it really, that might be the thing that really helps the Wii U in the future. So those are just some of the thoughts I have about the future of Wii U. I don't know, I really hope that the Wii U does as well as it can. Because it is an interesting culture, an interesting console with an interesting gimmicky mechanic. And I always love what Nintendo tries to do because they always try to do something on their own, you know? They don't care about what the other people do, really. They're not, like, they're in this corner doing their own thing. And sometimes it's kind of, you know, it's just like, what the fuck are you doing, Nintendo? Why are you being so stupid? But other times, it does seem like they're doing what they're doing. It's kind of cool, like, to see what happens from that. So those are my thoughts. Yeah. Cheers.